7 on me. I don't know if you could have been. No, it's not out. The volume is 600. So you hold on to it. Hold it. الحمد لله يا رب العالمين له الحمد في الأولى والآخرة في العصي والإبكار حين تحسين وحين تصبحون وله الحمد على كل حال يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله خلق فسوى وقدر فهدى وهو الذي في السماء رب وإله يعبد ويطاع وهو أيضا في الأرض رب وإله يعبد ويطاع وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله شهادة قول وشهادة عمل شهادة إيمان وعمل صالح لم يتخذ صاحبة ولا ولدا وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وعزيزنا محمدا صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم عبده ورسوله ما آتاك الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا وما كان بمؤمن ولا مؤمنة إذا قضى الله ورسوله أمرا أن يكون لهم الخيرة من أمرهم فرجعوا الله ورسوله فقد ضل ضلالا بعيدا. أما بعد، go directly to Allah's word, refresh and replenish our minds, hearts, concerning this once in a year exercise. Allah, tolerate no doubt. Allah's words are the following: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. أياما معدودات، فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخرى، وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين، فمن تطوع خيرا فهو خير له، وأن تصوموا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم، ومن كان مريضا او على سفر فعدة من ايام اخر، يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر، ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. We will make do, even though there are following ayat and instructions, we will make do with this amount. Life-sustaining ayat tell us the following: O you who are securely, or who are secure in your commitment to Allah, يا أيها الذين آمنوا. This expression, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, is repeated probably over 100 times in the Quran. And when Allah, Taala, when He addresses us with these words, He expects us to fulfill the assignment that follows. There are other forms of address in the Quran. Allah says, Ya ayyuhal nas. Allah says, Ya ayyuhal ladina utul kitab. Allah says, Ya bani Adam. But here, and in the similar ayat in the Quran, what is to follow is a policy or an assignment. Something that requires a collective effort and an organized and disciplined method and approach. Qiyam is not just a personal responsibility. Qiyam is a social responsibility. يا أيها الذين آمنوا يا أيها الذين آمنوا. Now Allah takes us into the socialization of the coming order or instruction or in this case an institution. يا أيها الذين آمنوا. And this is something that has escaped the average Muslim when he reads the Quran. Little does he notice that after Allah Jalla wa Ala says يا أيها الذين آمنوا, then the following statement or sentence has to do with organizing the Islamic social reality. It's not just when we fast, Allah says, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ. Fasting has become your assignment. He didn't say, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكَ الصِّيَامِ as an individual. And this is where we live today. Fasting has become an individual obligation. It no longer is pertaining to يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا and كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمْ. No longer is Ramadan within this definition. It has receded. It has retreated. It has lost its social dimension to become what it is today. An individual responsibility. This is the way we approach and we exercise our fast. Which is not the way that is meant by the meaning of these ayat. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykumu siyam kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum, as was the assignment of those who came before you. Pause a moment here. Think that Muslims who are listening to this Quran have inherited an assignment that, had it not been for this Quran, the whole assignment would have been lost. There were nations, there were people of Scripture before this Quran who also were tasked with fasting. Where is that task now? Look at people of previous revelations, of prior scriptures? How? What do they fast? What does fasting mean to them? The concept, the idea of fasting has become mutilated in those who have shared the responsibilities of scripture before this Quran. For some people, fasting means we fast 24 hours one day a year. Is this a social institution? To other people, it means you abstain from meat for one day a week or for 40 days a year. This fasting, so it calls on us to move this responsibility into future generations and to reinstitutionalize it within its social dimension. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم. It is a matter of humble pride that it falls on us, the students of the Prophet and the disciples of the Quran, it falls on us to fulfill this task of Qiyam. But what is it about? Why do we fast? Why are we doing this month of fasting? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Once again, we encounter the socialization of the fast. There's a plural here. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا is a number of people. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمْ on you as a plural of people. And then fasting has been assigned to us for the purpose that لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Once again, we are looking at a congregation of people, a congress of people. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. All reference in this ayah to people in their multitude and masses. There is not one word in this ayah that refers to an individual or one person. So Ramadan and fasting, abstaining from food and water, nourishment, and the desires of the self, this act is meant to be for society, not for an individual, or even not for individuals. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. What the objective is when we fast, لعلكم تتقون, so that you may guard, so you may be on guard against Allah. This is a taqwa. One of the ways of explaining a taqwa is there is a sense of avoiding greed in our civic life. We try to avoid breaking the law. Why? because the there's going to be consequences of penalties and punishments. Anyone who breaks the law is going to run into the legal system, the verdict, and whatever comes out of that. A sentence in jail, community service, death penalty, whatever the case may be. This feeling, trying to avoid breaking the law, is in the linguistic sense a taqwa. Everyone in himself has a sense, has a feeling, has a consciousness of, if at all possible, we're not going to run against the law. It is this meaning that Allah is referring to when He places the word لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ in this ayah. He does not want us to run afoul of Him. This is what is meant by fasting. And this cannot be accomplished when we are fasting only as individuals. It can be achieved when this collective fast becomes a social institution, something that has been absent from Islamic public life for centuries. We have been reduced to something like the fasting of the ego. It's become so private and so personal that even to come to re-explain the objectives of fasting in society and the social order around us seems strange to our ears. And it shouldn't be, because it is calculated in these ayahs. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Once again, think, focus, concentrate on the particulars in this ayah. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمْ الْقِيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The multiple repetition of the plural in this ayah leaves a thinking person no choice but to begin to think about Ramadan in its social scope, in its social depth, in its social inclusiveness. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Why, if this is the case, if this is our understanding of the ayah, then why do we have the Ramadan coming and going in previous years, this year, and if things continue at this pace, in the coming year, when we are fasting during this month of Ramadan, but this fast doesn't have a social impact? Maybe one of the hadith of Allah's blessed prophet will explain a little more about this. محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة في أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. وده في الحديث مين؟ Whoever does not part with the expression of fraud and the actualization of fraud, then Allah has no interest in him parting with his food and water. This is in reference to our fast. We know alphabetically that fasting means we don't eat, we don't drink, and we don't have conjugal relations if we are married. During the day, Allah's prophet, and Allah's teaching, let me be a prophet, is telling us Allah has no need for us abstaining from food and water and our desires if we are not abstaining from fraudulent expressions and fraudulent acts. So why are people, if they are fasting, why are they at the same time part of a larger fraud in this world? You look at the politics, the economics, the education, the entertainment, the socialization, almost everything that is going on in our own society, Ramadan is social. We understand that from the very first ayah here in Surah Al-Baqarah. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. But who, we ask ourselves, who are the Muslims who are withdrawing from this fraud, from the social fraud, from the political fraud, from the economic fraud that has become the fiber and the fabric of the society that we are in? Who are the Muslims by parting with their food and water and desires are at the same time parting from this pronounced fraud around us? There's an answer to this, and they are on the lesser side, numeric. Not many people doing this. What brings them to Ramadan is the force of tradition. And then the way they observe Ramadan is also a matter of culture and tradition. Therefore, we have no social Ramadan. Because we don't see that Muslims, around 2 billion Muslims in this world, we don't see around 2 billion Muslims making a serious attempt as they withdraw from food and water, also withdrawing from the corruption and the fraudulent policies all around them. And there's plenty of them. There's no lack of this. What happened? There's a dysfunction of the fasting that we are observing. It doesn't take its social range.
what? Did someone make up this hadith? No. It is there for all to listen to and refer to. مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعْ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةٌ فِي أَنْ يَدَعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. But why do we have the average Muslim incapable of absorbing this understanding of the fact? Why is that so? Because there is no word that plant with some kind of hurt. Because there is no confidence in Allah Jalla wa Ala. They look around, Muslims today, they look around and see, wow, there's a big military force flexing its muscle, dispatching its armada, striking with its aircraft. So what if that is the case? Is not Allah more powerful, more forceful, more potent than what you are looking at? If you don't withdraw from this fraudulent impression that has deep, deep down inside the recesses of your feelings and your heart, then what does it mean to be fasting? مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعْ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةٌ فِي أَنْ يَدَعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. We expect who to take the initiative to say we no longer are part of this global fraud? Who's going to do that? King so-and-so in Arabia, or President so-and-so in Africa? Are they fasting according to the standards and the meaning of these ayats and the hadith of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wassalam? Ramadan would have an impact on the world if one third of humanity is fasting, the Muslims of the human race, if they are observing a social fast. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Where is this taqwa? Is there a heightened sense of not running afoul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is there a sharp sense that develops through our fasting not to break the laws of Allah? Compare your own internal self and our internal social self. Make that connection and make that leap. Allah subhanahu never meant for you to be incarcerated within your own individual self He also wants you to think about your social self, something that never is expressed and radiated from these manabir under occupation. Think of the average Muhammad and Uthman and Ali and the rest of these Muslims. Think of the way they compare breaking the law of man with breaking the law of Allah. Where is a taqwa in this comparison? They are more afraid of breaking the secular law than they are of breaking the Islamic and the scriptural law. Where is the taqwa? Where is Ramadan? Where is a siyam? Siyam is a matter of discipline. It takes discipline, organization, patience to observe these vital meanings in our social self, not in our personal self. Take a look at our social psychology. Where is a taqwa therein? You can extend that and take a look at our rulers. Are they fasting the month of Ramadan, fulfilling the meanings of these ayat? And the straight answer to that is no. Allah's Prophet furthermore states, رُبَّ صَائِمٍ مَا لَهُ مِنْ صَوْمِهِ إِلَّا الْجُوعُ وَالْعَطَشُ. You may have a person who is fasting, but who gets nothing out of his fast except hunger and thirst. That's a physical fact. And Allah doesn't want us to be only physical or material human beings. He wants us to extend that so that we realize that we are accountable to Him and only to Him. This what Ramadan are, these the types of meanings that begin to take hold during these days and weeks of Siyam? One of the companions of Allah's Prophet said, لكل شيء زكاة وزكاة بدن الصيام. For everything there is a zakat. For every privilege, for every bounty, for every provision that Allah has given you, you give out of it as a form of purifying and elaborating what Allah has given you. If He has given you money, you give out of that money, so the money left which you have will grow and prosper in a method of halal. If Allah has given you tithe, you share this tithe with others who are in need of it. Allah has given us a body, and the zakah for this body is to fast.